And right now joining us is Tom Kline, an attorney for victim number 5. Tom, thanks so much for being here. Let me begin. I want you to tell me, as a result of what has been revealed and uncovered by this investigation and this report, what does it tell us about the responsibility and what was done to these victims and who is responsible for it, Tom?
Well, while Mr. Freeh did not use these words, I sure will. There was a colossal and monumental failure at the highest levels of Penn State. Mr. Freeh, both in the report and then later in the news conference, which I attended, puts the blame squarely on 4 men. President Spanier, Vice President Schultz, Athletic Director Curley, and yes, Coach Paterno. They all knew back in 1998, and this is the headline out of this whole report, in my view, for those of us who know the weeds, not just the headlines. In 1998, they all knew, and they had information that Mr. Sandusky was a predator. They thought about it. Mr. Schultz in notes actually contemplated it, yet they did nothing about it. If you fast forward to 2001, the emails which had been leaked and had been part of the public domain already were the second big focus. In 2001, once again, these 4 men knew and understood that Sandusky was a risk, yet they consciously collaborated together. Conscious collaboration not to tell authorities, not to tell the public, not to tell the Board of Trustees. The other headline, which is interesting, is that the trustees themselves are criticized very much so by Mr. Freeh. And all of this, of course, has the imprimatur of a former FBI director and federal judge. Those are my takeaways. Colossal and monumental failure at the highest levels.
I just want to make clear, and this report has come out, I just want to make it clear here at this point that Mr. Spanier, Mr. Schultz, Mr. Curley are welcome on this program at any point, as are the members of Joe Paterno's family welcome on this program to give their side, their perspective on all this at any moment. It's 877-JUROR13 if you want to call in. Okay, they are welcome, obviously. We want to hear their side of the story as well. But we're hearing from Louis Freeh today. So, Tom Kline, from your perspective, do you believe, are you convinced that all these men should have done something, could have done something, and didn't do it to protect the university and the football program?
There is no doubt in my mind, first, that all of these men acted in concert and deliberately did nothing. The connecting of the dots as to what was in their mind and why they did it, I would leave for a jury another day, maybe the jury of public opinion. I certainly believe that they must have had a motivation, and that motivation had something to do with who Mr. Sandusky was, how prominent the football program was, and just what it all, what any of this type of information would mean to the program. They put football ahead of the reputation of the university, as it turned out. I know the Paterno family is busy saying that this is not about football through the posthumous statement of Coach Paterno himself. But the fact of the matter is, all of this happened within the confines of the football program. The thing that's staggering to me, just staggering, is that in 1998 and then reaffirmed in 2001, these men, who by the way were deeply and intimately involved in the football program, certainly Curley and Paterno, these men knew that this man was a grave risk to youngsters. Yet they watched him with their very own eyes parade these youngsters around like trophies. My word, the conduct, rightfully so, is described by Louis Freeh today as conscious disregard for the victims who came. And last point as to this answer, in August of 2001, the young man I represent, then a young boy of 13, was molested in the shower when they knew and they had knowledge in February of 2001 and all discussed it, and back in 1998 discussed it previously. They were a direct contributing factor of the horrible things that happened to the young man I represent.
Tom, one final question to you, and this is based upon what has come out today in this report as a result of Louis Freeh's investigation. What is the question that, in your mind, is still unanswered?
There are two that jumped out at me. One is that I see nothing in my brief review of the 267-page Freeh report that addresses 1968 through 1998 in any kind of depth or detail. And it defies logic or imagination that nothing was happening in that period. That's one thing. The second thing, which is a dot that at least from my perspective I connect, that Mr. Freeh did not connect, has to do with 1998 and 1999. In 1998, Mr. Sandusky was, of course, in the shower, and the mother complained that he had wet hair, and these four men talked about that internally. Now, in 1999, Mr. Paterno is at a retirement function, essentially, of Mr. Sandusky. Sandusky retires in the height of his ascendancy and primacy as the defensive coach of one of the most dominant university football programs. That doesn't connect to me. In my view, that dot by circumstantial evidence is connected. I didn't see Mr. Freeh connected. I'm going to read it more carefully, but he just doesn't believe he had documents or evidence. At least that was the implication I got at his news conference today. Those are two things that strike me as someone who I think is pretty knowledgeable about this.
Tom Kline, great to speak with you. Thanks so much. Appreciate it.